In this video, you will learn how to calculate and interpret slope and elasticity of demand. Many students think that especially the concept of elasticity is very difficult.
No, it's not. Even a kid could do it.
What will you learn? You will learn how to calculate slope in a market diagram, and you will also learn how to interpret slope. Then we switch to the concept of elasticity. You will learn how to calculate elasticity, how to use the midpoint formula to find the middle between two points, and finally you will learn how to interpret price elasticity of demand and how to distinguish it from slope.
Here we have a demand curve. If the price is 8 and we go straight to the curve and then go straight down, we can see the quantity demanded is 6. And if the price increases from 8 to 12, then if we go again to the demand curve, then straight down, we can see that the quantity demanded decreased by 2 from 6 to 4. How can we calculate and interpret the slope? In school, you learned that slope is rise over run. In economics, we have a problem. The problem is that in economics, we exchange the axis in the market diagram. The independent variable is on the vertical axis, while the dependent variable is on the horizontal axis. Consequently, we have to change how we interpret the slope. The new slope would be run over rise. So the change of quantity over the change of price. So we calculate the slope parameter as run over rise. So what is a rise? The price actually increased from 8 to 12, so it increased by 4. And as a consequence, the quantity demanded decreased from 6 to 4, which is a decrease by negative 2. So we have negative 2 over 4, which equals negative 0.5. That means if the price increases by $1, then the quantity demanded will decrease by half a unit. How do we calculate elasticity and what is the difference compared to slope? Elasticity is actually the percentage run over the percentage rise. So we have to calculate the percentage change of quantity over the percentage change of price. What is the percentage change of price? Well, we know already the absolute change was 4. So we just have to divide by the level. The problem is, should we divide by 8 or should we divide by 12 by this point? What we do, we choose a compromise and take the midpoint, and the midpoint between 8 and 12 is actually 10. Well, this was obvious to see here, but often it is not that obvious to see how the midpoint can be calculated. Therefore, we have a formula. The midpoint formula tells us add the two numbers and divide by 12. Let's do that for the quantity. We want to find the quantity here between 6 and 4, the midpoint, so we add 4 plus 6, which is 10, divided by 2, and as a result, as a midpoint, we get 5. So, for the percentage change of price, we divide negative 2, which was the absolute change, by 5. And what we get is, the percentage change of quantity is actually 2 divided by 5, and it was negative 2 divided by 5, which is 40%. We write it here as 0.4. And 4 divided by 10, by accident, is also 0.4 or 40%. So we have an elasticity here of negative 1. What does it mean? It means if the price changes by 1%, the quantity demanded will decrease also by 1%. So for every percentage change of price of 1%, the quantity demanded will also change by 1%. If the price changes 2%, then, because we have a 1 here, the quantity change would be the same, the quantity would decrease by 2%. I hope you learned about how to calculate slope and elasticity, and even more important, how to interpret slope and elasticity. Goodbye, and I hope to see you in the next video.